We want to solve the given rational inequality, the quantity x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 3 is greater than 0. So we want to find all the x values that make this fraction greater than 0. In general, to solve a rational inequality, we want to start by factoring the numerator and denominator, then determine the zeros of the numerator and denominator. Then we're going to plot these points on the number line, which will divide the number line into intervals, and then we'll test each interval to see which intervals satisfy the original inequality. So starting with the numerator, x plus 2 will equal 0 when x equals negative 2. And then for the denominator, x minus 3 is equal to 0 when x equals 3. So now we'll plot these values on the number line, but when it comes to plotting the zeros of the numerator, we do have to pay close attention as to whether we should plot these as open points or closed points. This is based upon the original inequality. Notice when x equals negative 2, the numerator is equal to 0, and therefore this fraction would equal 0. But we want to know when this fraction is greater than 0. So negative 2 is not going to be a solution to this inequality. Therefore, we make an open point on negative 2. If it said greater than or equal to, then we'd make a closed point on negative 2, because negative 2 would be part of the solution. And then the zeros of the denominator are always going to be open points because, remember, these are the values of x where we'd have division by 0, which is undefined. So we'll make an open point on positive 3 as well, excluding positive 3 as a possible solution. And now notice we have three intervals to test, the left, the middle, and the right. So let's select x equals negative 3 for this interval, x equals 0 for the middle interval, and how about x equals 4 for the right interval? So if these values are true or false, it tells us whether the entire interval is true or false. So for x equals negative 3, notice how we'd have negative 3 plus 2, that's negative 1, all over negative 3 minus 3, that's negative 6, which equals positive 1/6. Well, 1/6 is greater than 0, which means this is true, and therefore this entire interval would be true. So let's go ahead and graph this entire interval as part of our solution. Now we'll test x equals 0. Well, when x is 0, the numerator is 2, the denominator is negative 3. Well, negative 2/3 is not greater than 0. So this entire interval would be false. And therefore, it's not part of the solution. And then for x equals 4, we would have 4 plus 2, that's 6. All over 4 minus 3 is 1. Well, 6 is greater than 0. And since this is true, this entire interval is true and therefore part of the solution. So we'll go ahead and graph this interval as well. So this is the graph of our solution. Let's also express this using interval notation and inequalities. To the left, we're approaching negative infinity. To the right, we're approaching positive infinity. So using interval notation, the interval on the left would be from negative infinity to negative 2, open on negative 2, union, the interval from 3 to infinity, open on 3. Or if we want, using inequalities, x is less than negative 2 or x is greater than 3. There's also a way to check this solution graphically, so let's take a look at how we can do this. If we want to solve this inequality graphically, or determine when this fraction is greater than 0, we could graph the function y equals the quantity x plus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 3. And then we can ask, when is the function greater than 0, or when is y greater than 0? Well, that would be when the graph of the function is above the x-axis, because above the x-axis, all the y-coordinates are greater than 0. So if we focus in on this left part of the graph, notice that to the left of negative 2, the blue graph is above the x-axis, and therefore these values of x would satisfy the original inequality. And because it's not equal to 0, only greater than 0, we would not include negative 2 as part of the solution. So we'd have x is less than negative 2 here. Then looking on the right, again, we know x can't equal positive 3 because we'd have division by 0, which graphically means we have a vertical asymptote here, so we must exclude positive 3, But notice to the right of positive 3, again, the graph is above the x-axis, and therefore these x values would satisfy the original inequality. So looking at the intervals on the x-axis, notice how these match our solutions from the previous screen. So I think verifying our solutions graphically is a nice way to double check our work. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.